Welcome everyone. I put this video as a must-see. And normally when I'm watching videos, I want to get straight to the point, see what's wrong, and see if I can fix myself. So I want to give you a backstory, because the reason this is a must-see is you've got to understand the backstory. So this is my older Endeavor Holiday Rambler RV, and we were driving along through Kansas. We took a trip from Wisconsin all the way out to Arizona, up through Vegas, and back around. On our way back, when we went through Kansas, driving along, she just died on the side, or as I was driving, no throttle, no nothing, all the lights are working, I pull over. Some really nice guy, by the way, by a farm, hooked on with his pickup truck, pulled this entire RV with a Jeep behind it, all the way to his land, and gave us a free, as long as we wanted to stay, gave us power, everything. Side note. Anyway, I called up, I had somebody show up, they put a scanner on it, and they said, I think it's your injection pump. Nothing I can do for you on the road. Now, I didn't look at the exact code. I was already pissed, so whatever. I had a big, huge tow truck tow us there. We got to this Maupin in Dodge, Kansas. Now, I'm not too happy with these guys, but, you know, when you get towed somewhere, they got you by the mm-mms, and they know that they can charge you whatever they want. So they overcharged me by a ton on everything. But the real issue is that I don't believe it ever was the injection pump. So they put the injection pump in, and they still weren't getting this thing running. They told me they had a problem. They accidentally screwed something up, and they had to reset some ECM stuff, and they had to call Cummins and Freightliner and blah, 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 blah. Well, in the end, again, I do not think it was the injection pump. This company was not honest with me, and of course, left the injection pump in, made me pay for it, and went ahead and fixed whatever they did or figured out how to get it to work. So anyway, let's go inside and I'll show you more. Okay, so now we're sitting inside the RV. To give you my story here, we decided to take another trip towards Vegas, but this time from Colorado, where we're staying. And we drove all the way to Vegas. We drove down through Phoenix, Arizona, and back. And we had no issues. Everything went great. We hit some snowstorms. But you know what? We got back to Colorado pretty late. Backed the RV into its stall where you just saw it. And came back about a month and a half later and just cranks. Won't start. No, nothing I can figure out. So I then brought another guy in. This guy started looking at things and says, it's the injection pump. Now I've got 12,000 miles on this other injection pump straight from Cummins. And I just don't believe it's the injection pump. I don't believe this. So this is where the story begins of a company called Thoroughbred Diesel. Now these guys, to me, are amazing. I have nothing to do with them, not associated to them. They're not even knowing I'm making this video. But I called these guys up, I talked to this Vince guy, and they make a breakout box. So let me show you this breakout box. So here's the breakout box. This is the connector that goes on the back of the injection pump. And this is the control of it. The light lights up when you power it on. Here's your high and low, and here's your shutoff. Now the goal of this is to test the injection pump and make sure it's that or something else. See if the injection pump is actually working. So this thing is very, very simple to hook up. You take it and mount it to the injection pump down in there, and then power and ground, and that's it. When you hook this thing up, you can figure out if things are going on. So a tiny bit more of a backstory is the guy that came out to help me with this 24 valve Cummins here, he again thought it was the injection pump. But what we noticed is this Maupin place, they didn't replace the lift pump. And everybody tells you should put a lift pump on when you put an injection pump on, because the lift pump can kill your injection pump. So I agreed, we put a lift pump on it, still no go. So what was going on is when I would turn the key on, down underneath here is your lift pump. It's kind of buried underneath here. Here's your fuel filter. And the lift pump would make a little sound like it turned on, like an eh, and that's it. And it would act like it's doing something, but it wouldn't go on for more than a split second. When they put the new lift pump on, it did pump some fuel out. But I think what was going on is there was fuel on the line. So I'm not sure totally what's wrong with this engine yet or what's going on, but I know it's not the engine and I know it's not the lift pump, and we'll get to that. But when I started helping out trying to diagnose this, I had no fuel coming out of the lift pump. I'd turn it on, nothing come out, and I needed to figure out why. So I'm like, I'm not buying a lift pump, I'm not buying anything until I prove that I have fuel and that we're good to go. So let me get this quick hooked up, and then I will show you my next steps. Here we go. We are completely hooked up. I will give you a picture of down in there, but I have their cord hooked to the injection pump over to their controller over here. You'll see I've got power. She is plugged into the battery. Running cords out my window. They give a really long cord, so it is nice. The lift pump down here I disconnected because, again, whatever is going on, I'm not getting full power to it for long. So what I do is I got two wires. I did put a little toggle switch on for the power. When you power it on, you hear the lift pump start pumping. Now, when I was testing it earlier, I took this Allen wrench plug out, and all you could hear was air. You didn't really see any fuel come out. So I hooked a 5-foot hose, caught here on the exhaust, but I took this 5-foot hose and I ran it down to the injection pump. And what I will be doing is plugging it into there. Okay, so now I've got it plugged in a little strange. I get that. Or the hose is in the end of the gas cap here, or gas nozzle. And the reason I did this is I loosened up this top screw again. And what I'm doing, and it's going to be hard to show you this, but I'm lifting the gas can up and pouring fuel into that hose, kind of priming the pump. This mechanic that was here said sometimes these pumps need to be primed. Not sure if they do or not, but it seems to definitely help. So I cracked the pump on for a split second, and I make sure that I see fuel coming out of there, so I know the pump is pumping. And now I'll disconnect this and put it into the can. Screw down there is definitely tight. You do not want air going into the system. And you may have to crack and bleed the injectors to get this to start. I was told you're supposed to bleed 1, 3, and 4. Okay, so again, 5-foot hose coming from the injection pump that used to go to the front of the RV's gas tank directly into the fuel. This device, the breakout box hooked up. This to turn the pump on, the lift pump on. And the reason I do this is I'm not sure if you should leave the lift pump running without the engine running for long. I don't know what it's doing. I'm not sure. I used to be a mechanic, but I'm not one. So what I do is I'm going to click this button and I'm going to run to the front of the RV and we're going to crank this over. And we'll show what this does. Now, it may start a little rough because I'm one person right now and I can't really bleed these injectors by myself right this second. So at least I'm not sure how to do that the correct way by myself. Let me get this going. Okay, so we're going to give this thing a start, and then I got to show you how this breakout box works again. So I'm going to turn the pump on, run to the front. Okay, what I'm going to show you is this breakout box has a high-low. When you hit the button, it puts it in high. When you hold it, it goes off. This button will shut it down. When this thing is running, let me shut my pump off. When this thing is up and running, to prove, according to Thoroughbred Diesel, to prove that the injection pump is taking commands, you hit this button once, and it turns it to high idle. You hold it after that, and while you're holding it, it should be on low idle. When you let it up, it should be on high. And then you can hold this and shut her down. You will not be able to shut it down with the key. However, as you can see, this thing is running, and the injection pump is doing all of its things. Now, again, it starts a little rough. I'm sure I got air in the injectors. I need to get that straightened up. But at this point, I think what you can see with the must is, I would have spent, even with Thoroughbred Diesel at a great price of $1,100 two-year warranty, I still would have spent $1,100 plus all the money to install it, and it probably still wouldn't have started when it's done. So what this means is I saved money first. I believe, and according to Thoroughbred Diesel, that injection pump should be fine. We know internally it's not broke, you know, mechanically. We do know that it is taking commands with their tool. And according to them, this is a Cummins tool. It has Cummins written on it. So that this is how they also test. Now, I don't know if I have an ECM problem. I don't know if I just have a bad ground, a bad power. I have found some strange things that happened because when we went through that snowstorm. But as of now, I'm not really sure what's wrong, and we're going to figure that out. I will make a second video to let you know what I have found. But as of now, I saved a lot of money and I don't have an injection pump on order right now. So the other point of this is Thoroughbred more or less helped me diagnose this, and they didn't even get a sale out of this. I didn't buy that injection pump from them. They helped me so much that I wish I could buy an ECM from them if that's what I could do. They don't sell the ECM. But how many companies can you say will do that for you in today's world? How many companies will put you, the customer, first and not a profit and not go by all this other crap and say, oh, just order one. And you know what? The minute you touch that, too bad, you're not returning it. Good luck. So anyway, thanks for watching. I really hope this helps you with your 5.9 Cummins. And maybe check out my next video when I get it out, if I can get this thing running. Thanks.